You're listening to Saturday Morning Media. And now, back to our show. My name is Grant Baciocco, and I invite you to join me on my quest to learn about and experience every Disney park attraction I possibly can. This is Attraction Checklist. Welcome to the Attraction Checklist. My name is Grant Baciocco. The episode for this week is not for the faint of heart, as we are riding the classic It's a Small World at Disneyland Park in Anaheim, California. Now, the official guide map describes this ride in the following manner. Take off on a whimsical boat ride past a joyful congregation of singing children from around the globe. According to the thrill level in the guide, the ride is slow, a water ride, and loud. Yeah, loud. Well, here's five fast facts about this attraction. Fact number one, the ride features over 300 audio animatronic dolls in traditional costumes from around the world. According to Wikipedia, each doll's face is completely identical in shape. Fact number two, this attraction originally debuted in the 1964 New York World's Fair in the UNICEF Pavilion and was sponsored by Pepsi. It opened in its new home in Disneyland Park on May 28, 1966. Fact number three, the design team consisted of Mary Blair, Mark and Alice Davis, Raleigh Crump, and Blaine Gibson. Fact number four, the attraction's song, which you will soon become very familiar with if you're not already, was written by the Sherman Brothers, who originally demoed it for Walt as a slow ballad. Now, Walt wanted something more cheerful, so the Sherman Brothers sped up the tempo a bit and sang it in counterpoint, and that's the song we have today. And fact number five, when I worked at Disneyland, there was an event for employees called the It's a Small World 5K that raised money for charity. Now, this was not a running 5K. This was a 5K where cast members rode It's a Small World straight through enough times to travel the distance of 5 kilometers or 3 miles. The next year, they changed the 5K to Pirates of the Caribbean. So now let's take a ride on It's a Small World. And the good news is we aren't riding alone. Dave Marquez, who's also a former cast member and a good friend, is riding along with us, and he and I will discuss our thoughts and feelings on the ride after it's over. Here now is It's a Small World on Attraction Checklist.
Thank you. sentado hasta que el bote se detenga en el muelle y se le pida que desembarque. Gracias. Please remain seated until your boat comes to a complete stop at the dock and you are asked to disembark.
All right, Dave Marquez, we just rode It's a Small World. Do you like It's a Small World?
I love It's a Small World.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite part?
Or
favorite parts?
Probably Africa.
Yeah?
Go through Africa. There's a lot of what I want to say is Mark Davis art direction in there. And it's fun, and there's giggling hyenas and stuff, and, beats like a true 1960s Walt Disney score. Like, you could really feel the studio in it.
Yeah. Yeah, I think one of my favorite parts, I have little things that I just think are funny. Like, I think the geese are hilarious, quacking along. I know they're iconic, but...
They are, and you know what? These are newer ones that are in there, but they look like wood to me. Like, the old ones, I'd rather see their faces falling off, the ones from 1964.
Yeah.
But these look like wood. I don't know.
Yeah, I like those, but one of my other favorite little details is in the, sort of the, I guess the England, UK section, England section, is the little boy holding the frog.
Oh,
he's
yeah,
up above.
He says, boo to school or something. Boo to school.
Yeah, then the kid's holding the frog, and the frog's a twig. And then it looks like there's no front legs on the frog.
Yeah.
So are we supposed to believe that the kid has pulled the legs off of a frog? I don't know.
I don't know, but it's kind of moving.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's just sort of twitching in its weird death throes. Yeah, but
there's another gag in there, I don't know if you've noticed, and I was looking at it as we went through today, and I've seen it many times, but I never really looked at it. There are two clowns on the top of the, going through Great Britain, above the soldiers as you're going through, right under what you're talking about. There's like two clowns up there with umbrellas, and one umbrella is perfect, but the other one is shooting up, and I think the gag might be that the band is blowing so hard that it blew the
umbrella
up. I think.
I'll have to look at that.
Yeah.
I have not noticed that.
I've noticed it many times. I've just never really paid attention to it.
Because it kind of moves. The umbrella, it's like opening and closing.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's going the other direction.
Yeah. What do you think about it was a couple of years or so ago, but adding the Disney characters. Does that bother you?
No. I understand why they did it in China. And I guess I understand why they did it here for marketing reasons. A lot of those characters... They're iconic, but they're awfully American, so I don't think they're necessary.
Mm.
But I mean, if you could put it in the minds of kids even more throughout the day, and they see it in a different light, in a doll form, there's no reason to not to exit the attraction and enter the nice little Mattel toy shop where you can purchase that exact same doll.
Right.
So, I mean, I understand it from a business standpoint, but for an entertainment value, it does nothing for the show.
The one thing I noticed today is, they put Ariel, the Little Mermaid, in the mermaid section, but now her voice is loud and clear, and I guess that's because it's Ariel and she's a beautiful singer, but I liked when it sounded like they were all underwater and they were singing. To me, that was fun.
Yeah, and then at Christmas, of course, she sings Jingle Shells
right.
as you go through there.
Right. Well, Dave, on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being your favorite attraction of all time, 1 being never, what will you give It's a Small World?
Oh, it's a 9.5/10.
Wow,
sure.
Really? That high?
Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of different reasons, too, why I'd say that is the story behind It's a Small World is, I think, pretty amazing from the 64 World's Fair. One little tiny piece of property left on the grounds, and Walt got it and then not only convinced Pepsi-Cola to give him money to build it, but I want to say this was the quickest attraction in Disney history, even in the 60s and today, that they designed it, wrote a score and a song, and built it and installed it in less than 6 months. So that's a damn pretty good achievement, and for it to be playing here 51 years later, and it's all over the world. I think they say this, It's a Small World, it plays nonstop 24 hours a day because of all the parks around the world.
The time changes.
I mean, I think it's pretty incredible. And when you see photos of Walt from probably 1963 and the Disneyland goes to the World Fair, Walt Disney Wonderful World of Color shows. He just looks awfully happy when he's with the Imagineers, Mary Blair, and all that stuff. But when you think about it, all the studio pieces and Walt Disney Productions are really in It's a Small World, and you really, really think about it. At least I do.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a good show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, Dave. Well, thank you.
Sure.
Dave Marquez was our guest this time on Attraction Checklist, and you can follow him over on Twitter at CWFHMarquez. There'll be a link to that in the show notes for this episode. Let me know which attraction you think we should experience next. Send me an email at grant@throwingtoasters.com, or you can give me a shout out on Twitter, where my username is @toasterboy. Sources for this episode include Disneyland.com and Wikipedia, so you know that they're true. Attraction Checklist is a production of Saturday Morning Media and made possible by the Saturday Morning Media Patreon patrons who have gone to www.patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media and set up a monthly donation for as little as $1 a month. Huge thanks to Shea Stewart, Merle Lafferty, Jeff Peterson, Dale Gadania, Stephen Staver, Jackie Klimo, Melissa Crawford, Chuck, Matthew Wayne Selznick, Dave Slusher of the Evil Genius Chronicles, Mike Coughlin, Dorothy Baciocco, John D., Kathy Crawford, Brian Greer, Carrie Whitney, Chuck Tomasi, Chris Foster, Stephen Ng, Clinton of ComedyForecast.com, Vicky DeVries, Mike Wabshaw, and Twitter user Butzinger, a.k.a. Wildcat. If you'd like to support this show and the other fun content from Saturday Morning Media, become a patron. Head on over to www.patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media. That's www.patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media, all one word, and set up your donation today. Or you can tell a friend about the show or leave the show a review on iTunes. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'll be back in 1 week with another attraction to check off the list. Attraction Checklist is copyright 2016 Saturday Morning Media, Grant Baciocco, executive producer. All rights reserved. www.saturdaymorningmedia.com. You've been listening to Saturday Morning Media. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.